Hi, everybody.
Hello there.
Jerry.
And Linda. And Gizmo.
We're the village's newcomers, and it's time for...
Send us your questions. We've got your answers. Jerry and Linda's Mailbag Monday.
This is the July 12 edition of Mailbag Monday. Yeah, buddy. We'll get to your part. Just keep your pants on back there. It's been hot here this week. Honestly, yesterday, it was only 89 degrees. But I felt like I almost got heat exhaustion playing golf. Yeah. I mean, I was taking liquids and it was so humid yesterday.
Yeah.
So I'm tell you what, I'm going to... We had a viewer send us two cooling towels.
Yeah.
I'm going to take those next time.
I
mean, I haven't been taking much water. And I haven't been taking cooling towels, but I'm gonna.
We've also had a friend that went down from the heat, and she had gotten taken to the hospital and everything.
That's right.
So, yeah, people drink your water here. You just can't take that for granted. Well, we sure dodged a bullet with the hurricane this last week.
We always take it seriously.
We
when
do.
When the weatherman says there are hurricanes, either in the Atlantic or the Gulf.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we take it seriously, but a near miss. It fizzled out, didn't it?
We did. We brought in the chairs and brought in all the things we needed to do and stocked up on things, but we're prepared and we do take it seriously.
Yeah, we're very thankful that it missed. We're in the interior section of Florida, as you know, and not usually hit nearly as hard as the coastal areas, but still we take precautions. And and thanks for all of you that wrote in and said, how are you? And they're praying for our safety and so forth. And we appreciate that so much. Let's start off with some shout outs. We had a big surprise the other day. We got a care package in the mail from our friends at the Hackers Paradise, Josh and Morgan. And they sent us each a dozen golf balls. And that always comes in handy. Thank you so much for those. Appreciate it very much.
And Gizmo's been kind of lucky this week. He got two gifts. He got
Everybody loves Gizmo.
I know, Gizmo. He got a dog bowl from Mona and Clark, and it was a ceramic one that Mona made. And oh my gosh, it's lovely. We really appreciate that. And also a dog snack container from Tom and Peg in Ohio so he can take his treats with us. How generous. Thank you
really
so
nice.
Much.
And Kelly in Texas sent me a container, a big container, thank you very much, of sunblock. I still want to call it suntan lotion.
Yes.
But I mean, I'm not trying to suntan. I mean, look at me.
No.
I mean, no.
No suntan.
But sunblock. And Kelly, that was so nice of you. Thank you. And we got to go out with a couple that live in Orlando that are going to move here to the villages. And he's been a longtime viewer. It's Jose and Maria, and we had a great time with them. So
they're a special couple. They're really fun.
Yeah, they are. And all you people that are buying our T-shirts, as you know, we're not selling them, but this guy is, fourartsprints@gmail.com. He will send you an order form, and these folks are proudly wearing their Jerry and Linda T-shirts. We have a nice batch of questions today, but frankly, we need some more good questions. So if you're out there and you have something you think would be interesting to our audience, please send it to our email address, and there's it, villagesnewcomers@gmail.com, and we'll put it on the list. And if it's of interest to a wide range of people, we'll put it on Mailbag Monday. So thank you guys so much for keeping those questions coming in. Here's our first question of the day. Laura has the perception that I had of the villages, I think, before we came here. We hadn't even heard of it until our son mentioned it. I thought it was like that village in the movie Cocoon, you know, that movie with Don Ameche and Ray Bolger and Hume Cronin and Wilford Brimley. Great movie. Jessica Tandy was in that.
Oh, yeah.
I thought it was going to be like that little area there. But no, this is a huge, huge area. And Laura writes, is there any classism? where people from the built home neighborhoods don't associate with the trailer park neighbors. Well, first of all, when the villages first began up in Orange Blossom and Silver Lake, those were manufactured homes up there. But they haven't been built that way for over 30 years. All the homes, other homes in Spanish Springs and coming down to Sumter Landing and Brownwood and now down at Southern Oaks, they're stick-built homes. They're regularly constructed homes on site, and they're either going to be vinyl siding or concrete and block and stucco. So you're not going to have that now. But we still play golf with strangers a lot, don't we? If you go to the course, if she and I wanted to play golf at 10 o'clock on Monday morning, we'd put in to play. They're not going to give us a foursome by ourselves. They'll take another twosome, put them in with us. We've done it 100 times. And we don't ask them where they live. I don't ask them, what type home do you have before we play golf?
No.
Everybody's the same. You know, we all pay the same amenity fees. You know, we have the same access to everything.
Mm-hmm.
We have not seen any classism.
No. It's
in that regard, it's a great place to live.
This is from Marty. I was wondering if there are any good thrift shops in the area of the villages. And Marty, there are plenty. Inside and outside of the villages, you're going to find many areas and places to go shop those bargains, because when people move here, they switch out their decorations and their motif. And it's just great, because you're going to find great treasures there.
We all bring too much, right?
Yes,
down
we
here.
Do.
And it goes over. We had to get rid of a beautiful sofa. It wasn't 4 months old when we came here.
Yeah.
It just didn't fit with our motif.
Yes.
She works at one of the thrift stores.
I do.
She works at Bargains and Blessings,
right,
which is a nice one. In fact, didn't you bring some footage?
I did. And things are going off the shelves. It is an amazing place. This is the intake where we bring things. People will bring things in here. And it is so much fun to work here. And it is a blessing for the whole community, really.
Terry asks, which commercial aviation airports are the most convenient, least challenging to get to, use, and park at, and practical for flights if someone's visiting your area? Good question, Terry. We've covered this a little bit before, but you may remember, folks, we lived 20 minutes from a big, nice airport in Louisville, Kentucky. And now, that was 20 minutes away, we drive over an hour each way. So that's a little bit inconvenient. Who wants to fight traffic when you're tired, especially after a trip? But
yeah. But
we do it. The airports we use most often are Orlando International, which is MCO. That's about 1 hour and 6 minutes if everything goes smooth. There's an $11.60 toll, about $5.80 each way. Probably has gone up since I measured that, but it wouldn't be much. But that's the toll. Traffic has been a bear up there lately because of construction. It's like you'd have smooth sailing all the way to the airport and a traffic jam at the airport. So that's MCO. That's where you're going to be able most easily to get a ride from the villages to and from. Groom transportation, workman transportation. You've got a whole variety of private carriers that'll get you there too. So that's MCO Orlando. Another one that's popular for us is Tampa International, TPA. It's a little farther. It's about an hour 20, but it's a straight shot down the highway with no tolls. Easier access than Orlando, I think. So that's an option. And you won't be fighting that Disney traffic. That Disney traffic makes Orlando a busy airport. Another popular airport that we have never been to is Sanford. Sanford hosts some pretty inexpensive airlines, so it's a popular airport from the villages. And I think you can get some commercial delivery and drop-off from there. a hidden gem, you know,
yeah,
that we like to talk about is the Gainesville Airport. Gainesville's about 60 miles, takes an hour to get there, but it's an easy hour. The parking is a breeze and easy into and out of the terminal, but it's a tiny terminal. It's like the one you saw. If you ever watched the TV show Wings, it's kind of going to remind you of that one. But we like Gainesville. American Airlines flies in and out of there. Mm-hmm. So good question. We hope you'll find one that suits your needs.
This is from Kim. I know that there are now apartments in the villages for rent at the lofts, but are there any condos or townhouses for sale in the villages? Definitely yes, the lofts is for rent, but there are no apartments for rent. There are some townhouses in the Spanish Springs area, right outside of the town square, that you can check into. I think they go for $300,000, $400,000 maybe.
But they said those are few and far between,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, you can't get through this.
Might find a townhouse, but not mm-hmm. often. Mm-mm. No apartments. The Lofts is a really nice development there at Brownwood.
It's beautiful.
You must sign a year's lease for that.
That's right.
David and Ruthie are golfers. They say at their club they pay once a month for everything. Their green fees, card fees, and driving range. It's all one cost. Do any of the champion golf courses at the villages have that type of setup? No, they do not. Everybody here is eligible to play golf in the championship country club golf courses. Nobody plays for free. Nobody pays with a large membership. You can buy a priority membership, but that just gives you priority for tee times and a small discount on your green fee. You would pay that annually, and you'd get that discount. But as far as one fee fits all for your range balls, your golf, etc., no.
Joe and Robin ask, can you have a U.S. flag displayed in your front yard or front of your home? And absolutely, yes, we see lots of them.
We do. So mm-hmm. we took a little lap around the neighborhood, and we thought we'd show you some in our area.
Joe and Robin also ask, are the swimming pools heated? And yes, they are heated in the winter and fall months, about 83 or above. And they'll stop heating those in May when the weather gets better. So yeah, you're going to be able to go in the pool in the wintertime.
These pools are really well mm-hmm. maintained. You can almost always find people year-round mm-hmm. in our neighborhood pool outside. Right. Mm-hmm. Like she said, they're about 83 mm-hmm. in the winter. And although they're not heated in the summer, we took the grandkids here a week or two ago, and it was nice.
Beautiful.
Rita asks, are there churches in the villages, or do you go outside to church? Are there a variety of church choices in the area?
Oh, there are many choices for churches. You're going to find them all around the villages and outside the villages, 150 or more, I think. Newspaper on Saturday nights always advertising the churches. You're going to find every religion, every denomination. It's great.
The church that we've been going to is golf cart accessible for us. It would take us about 20, 25 minutes to get mm-hmm. there by golf cart. Mm-hmm. But many churches are not accessible. You would have to get in your car. Mm-hmm. But like she said, there's a little bit of it for everybody. I mean, just about any type of religion you can think of is represented mm-hmm. here, mm-hmm. and you're going to be able to find it. You may have to drive your car to it.
Oh, there's even one church that has outdoor viewing from your golf cart. It's like a drive-in. That's pretty awesome.
That's up in the Spanish Springs area, yeah. So that would be quite a drive for us. But yeah, this sounds neat, though, doesn't it? Jeff writes, I understand that you should park your golf cart to the side so more people can fit in the space. But say, for instance, if we have just one cart and we park in a spot on the side and three other carts are looking to park, could they park behind us and block us? Or are there rules that you don't block other carts? You know, there are rules You know, they're kind of unwritten rules.
Yes.
I have never seen a golf cart policeman.
No.
I have never seen a policeman ticket a golf cart for parking anywhere.
No.
But we decided to go down to the town square and take some footage. Take a look. This is an automobile parking spot right here. You can see two golf carts are parked. They're parked the correct way. One in the rear, halfway over, this one here. Now, these two folks probably don't know each other. If they did, they could stack park here because they'd be leaving at the same time. Here you'll see some automobile parking spots. Going to show you the proper way to park in a golf cart. She's pulled all the way up into there, allowing plenty of room for a cart to park over here. What happens if you park in the middle of one of these spaces?
Well, you get a proper cussing out in the villages. You have to definitely park on either one side or the other. Don't ever park in the middle when you're using a golf cart.
Linda's going to show you another one of her parking techniques. She spotted this Curtis cab, and she's going to try to park there, but it looks like they have parked too far over. She's going to go ahead in there. She made it work. But you can see that's the way to do it. Well, you can see Linda has improved dramatically from that first month we were here when she parked poorly and that irate citizen got in her face a little bit, made her cry.
I was tearful.
My goodness.
Yeah, parked right in the middle of the parking spot. You don't do that
no,
in your golf cart.
No. I live downtown, writes. My wife and I live in the Seattle metro area. It rains all the time, so we don't play golf. I play pool and darts, wondering if there are pool or dart leagues and tournaments. Yes and no. Another one of those. We have neighborhood rec centers. As far as I know, all of them have a beautiful room full of pool tables.
Yeah.
Six tables or eight. Beautiful tables. And it's a lovely place to play with the nice lights hanging down over the tables.
Right.
And they do have leagues. And you could go in that room and reserve it with buddies and go play. But darts, no. I called and asked. I called Rohan and asked one of the supervisors, and they could not think of any place in the villages where you could play darts. However, just about anything you want to do can be started here. You'd have to, you know, get enough people to sign up to make it worthwhile, and you could start your own dart league. I don't know if they'd have to be those kind of darts that don't make holes in the wall or what it would be, but you'd have to get that problem sorted out. But I think you could do that. I think you could find a place to play darts if you wanted to. And there's always some bars just outside the villages. I don't know if there are any in the villages that would play darts, but someplace out there, either in Leesburg or Wildwood or Fruitland Park or, you know, who knows. And they want to know, are there any places close for karaoke? And there are a few. We know Mystic Ice Cream has karaoke night.
Mm-hmm.
I think Belgrade has karaoke, probably some of the other country clubs.
Mm-hmm.
So you can find places to karaoke and bring out that inner singer in yourself.
Oh, there's a lot of talented people here.
Yeah, there are. Our buddy's Jake. He's a big karaoke guy. You saw Jake. Jake was the electric cart cowboy. He could sing with the best of them.
He can.
Brad wonders if there are any lakes where you have to catch and release, or can you keep a certain number? I'm a fisherman, Brad, as you probably know if you've watched our shows. I always catch and release.
Mm-hmm.
Always. If I caught a state record fish, he would go right back in the water. And that's the way it is throughout the villages. It's strongly recommended. However, there are lots of lakes around the outside of the villages. Mm-hmm. You got Lake Harris, Lake Weir. You've got Lake Eustis, Lake Dora, Lake Harris. You know, so many beautiful lakes. Some of them are renowned for their bass fishing, so you could go out there and keep fish if you want to. As far as license, if you are 65 or older and you live here, you don't need a license. But anybody under 65 is going to have a fishing license. Meyer asks, is there smoking permitted in common areas of the villages, both inside and outside? Meyer, I don't know.
I would not think there'd be anything inside. Would you think inside smoking? I haven't seen any. No.
But outside, for example, we ate at a local restaurant up at Sumter Landing a couple weeks ago. Mm-hmm. And our table was 15 feet away from the bar, and that wind was blowing our way, and that outdoor bar was letting people smoke. And that I was eating my seafood and some smoke at the same time.
Yeah, smoke and food.
I don't like it. I hate the smell of it. But it's allowed outside. Just hopefully whoever's smoking, and we understand that you're hooked on it or you just enjoy it. You know, it's your right. But, you know, please be considerate, especially if the wind's blowing like that.
Perry asks, do you intend to call yourself the Newcomers for a long time, or have you thought about a different title to switch in a while?
We get that question a lot. We answered it about a year ago.
Yeah.
So we'll go ahead and give it another shot since we haven't taken it for a while. We thought about it because it seems kind of funny that we've been here 2.5 years or so.
Yeah.
And although we still learn something every day, but we've decided to keep the name until further notice, because hopefully we're helping out newcomers.
That's right.
So we are, you know, newcomers.
Helping that newcomers.
Are getting over the newcomer badge, but we're still helping newcomers, so we are the newcomers. It's kind of our brand. Here is a question from my favorite person today on the question list. His name is Mark, but check this out. Mark is from Nottingham.
Yeah.
Think about Robin Hood. He's in England. And Mark from Nottingham asks, do you know if either Uber or Lyft are active in and around the villages? I had done this before, and I think I mentioned it before, but I did it again today to see if it had changed or if it was different. I don't like what I found out.
Uh-oh.
I got on my Uber app, which we have used Uber when we've been in London.
We did.
We have used it in
Washington, D.C.
In Rome, in Washington, D.C., in New York City, in Paris, France.
Yes.
We've used quite a bit. Mm-hmm. But nowhere have we been charged the kind of prices that I brought up today. Check this out. Mm. Our home is 5.8 miles from Sumter Landing. To UberX there costs $30.99. Our home from the hospital, if we had an appointment or something and we couldn't drive, like many people do, and we took Uber to the hospital, it's 9.4 miles. $43.94 this morning about 10 o'clock, I checked it.
Wow.
To the Everglades Rec Center down at Southern Oaks, that's only 6 miles, $28.90. This is for an UberX ride. Okay, you need an Uber to the airport. 60-mile trip, $163.90. It sounds to me like Uber is a difficult thing to use here.
Mm-hmm.
An expensive thing to use here. Mm-hmm. We'll often see on the Nextdoor app, someone will put an ad on there that says, can anybody take me to the VA center Tuesday at 9? And generally, you're going to find a nice person to do that. Mm-hmm. But these fees were a little unexpected for me. Mm-hmm. Another thing about spring and summer here, when we start getting the heavy rainfalls, these mushrooms start popping up everywhere. Now, it doesn't last all summer. It's just during this short window of time when it's wet and cloudy, these mushrooms pop up everywhere. I'm going to show you a few pictures. I wish we had done this last week because there were colonies of hundreds of mushrooms.
Yeah.
And now they're pretty much on the downside of it, but they're all over, aren't they?
It was a chore last week. Every morning when I'd take Gizmo out, I'd have a bag full in my front yard.
Yeah, we'd be pulling mushrooms. And we don't know if they're the kind you can eat or not. I don't think they are, but we didn't try.
No.
But take a look at some of these mushrooms. Well, thankfully, we're over the mushroom time, and mm-hmm. I can see it was harder and harder to find them today. Mm-hmm. So maybe it's going to warm up and the mushrooms will go bye-bye. It's that time.
Oh, no.
Time for our last question. Mm-hmm. We have put this question off for weeks and weeks now because I don't really understand the question. Ann and Rich write, my wife and I have no children, very little, if any, family or extended family and friends. Would moving to the villages be a good idea since the social aspect of the villages is enormous?
Social aspect.
Yeah. If you're asking, since you don't have friends and you come here, will you make friends? I would say yes.
Yes.
If you want to have friends.
Right.
But why don't you have any where you live? You know, if you don't get out.
Maybe they're too far away from people. Live in the
maybe
country.
Maybe so. Here, you're going to have the opportunity mm-hmm. to make friends. If you want friends, you got to get out and do it.
Yes.
Are people going to come knocking on your door wanting to be your friend? I doubt it.
No.
But the more activities you get in, the more friends you're going to make.
Mm-hmm.
The least number or less number of activities you get in, the fewer friends you'll have. So if that question means we don't want friends, you can do that too. You can do that wherever you live.
Uh-huh.
You guys like to hear from Gizmo. So Gizmo, what's on your mind this week?
Bob writes in and says, my wife has a service dog. Needless to say, he's always with her when she's out and about. Our concern is, during the summer months, is the pavement down there too hot for a dog to walk on? Bob, that is a great question. Now, I'm going to tell you something, and you might not believe it. I know that you're supposed to put your hand or your foot on the concrete, and if you can't leave it there a few seconds, then it's too hot for your dog. All right, I get it. But I want you to know that the grass here, it's like giant green needles. It's hard. It's pointy. And I don't like to walk on the grass. So actually, even in the summer, I prefer to walk on the asphalt or the concrete if I can. Now, my mom, she's always pushing me over to the grass. But I like to walk on the concrete, even when it's so hot out there that I saw a squirrel picking up nuts with pot holders. Okay, two jokes in one day. Here you go. What did the grape say when it got crushed? Nothing. Just let out a little whine. Whine! Get it?
He always comes up with something. He's a pretty funny dude. Listen, everybody, thank you so much for watching. We appreciate it. If you'll ring that bell, you'll see all of the upcoming videos that we put out. And maybe you'll hit that like and subscribe button and help us out there, too.
Until next time.
See you when you get here.